you have time. If you don't have, inshallah, you may proceed. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa man ittaba'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Inshallah, Ramadan is, the doors of Ramadan almost are going to open. And the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is around the corner. And we need to be prepared. And this is the blessing of this ummah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has does the ibadah, they don't stay the same. The ibadah, they change. So you have a certain ibadah that we do every day. And then you have a certain ibadah that we do every week. And then we have a certain ibadah that we do only once a year, like Ramadan. And then we have a certain ibadah that we only do once in a lifetime. And this is all something that keeps the Muslims or the believers not like a robot, but they actually fluctuate and they move around with the orders of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changed the orders, because sometimes you get a habit of doing something and it becomes like your second nature. And then what's the point? You come to the masjid, becomes like nothing for you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings another ibadah. And some of the ibadahs, they may be some easy for him, but they're not easy for you. And they may not easy for the other person. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has this mixture of variety of ibadah. Also, sometimes you may not do certain ibadah, but other person can do. Some people, they may not be able to fast during the year, but in Ramadan becomes an obligation. Inshallah, there is so many. One of the first mistake that all the Muslims we do all the time is that we do not know exactly how to begin Ramadan and how to end Ramadan. Can you believe? Ummah of this religion of Islam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them light and give them the Quran and give them the book and preserve the Quran for them. And even the Sunnah was preserved. And yet we have this disagreement amongst the first day, which one is the first day and which one is the sun. But if you look at the first generation of the Muslims, it's amazing. They never have a problem for almost 1,000 years. These things only started now. Because they believe in the word of Allah and they believe in the sunnah 100%. They have yaqeen. So they don't have a problem because they know exactly what it means. For example, I read this from ISNA when the Fifth Council in North America announcing the date of Ramadan. You know, they announced the day of Ramadan probably 10 years before. And inshallah, I will tell you some ahadith that I never know before myself until I check them up about this. And then they say Ramadan, the first day of Ramadan will be on Saturday, June 28, 2014. The first of the Shawwal will be on Monday, which is the Eid, on July the 28th. So they already finalized it for sure that Ramadan will be Saturday 28th. But as Ummah al-Islam that follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I, see, I read this so you know what they put, and then you read what Allah ta'ala says in the Quran. And what Allah ta'ala, he says, فَمَنْ, I'm going to clarify this because you can stay 2 hours just clarifying this, but I want you to understand with this simple mind. I just want you to have simple mind, people, to understand this, and then for the rest of your life, you don't have to, you know. And as Muslims, we do not say that the astronomical, because they say here was based on the astronomical. And listen to this. He says, the Fifth Council of North America recognized astronomical calculation as an acceptable Sharia. But it's never, it was never like this. The majority, all the ulama, they say the proper way of spotting the Hilal, which is the crescent, the beginning of Ramadan, is an eye thing. It's something to do with the eye. And I give you two ayat actually. I used to know one ayah, but today when I was looking, I said, Ya Allah, there is actually two ayah. There's two ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about this. The first one, you know, learn one thing, that you cannot change the understanding of the meaning unless you have a proof. I give you an example. I'll give you a small example. You cannot change the Arabic word, you cannot change it to another meaning unless you have a proof from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said such and such. Because he has the authority. But we cannot change this. I give you examples about this. And if you learn this in the Quran, you apply this rule in the whole Quran. When you read the Quran, you become almost like a mufassir, just like this. Because you take the Quran literally, what it means. That's what Allah meant. Allah didn't tell you this, and then He said there is another hidden meaning is outside. No, only few verses. Yes, we do. We do have verses that they you cannot take them out of the look. You have to understand them. And then also, only the ulama, the big major ulama, prominent, they have the tools. They have tools, you know, tools, the Quran, the Sunnah, the knowledge to interpret certain things. I'll give you an example. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ. We all memorize this, huh? فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ or فِي عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ. Can we change عَنْ by فِي? What's the difference? I want you to interact a little bit. Huge difference, my brothers. Amazing difference. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's promised the hellfire to those people who does not pray on time. If you change because of an salatihim, above the prayer, فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ, woe to those who actually pray, because He said, Allah said, المصلين, those who actually pray, but they do not pray on time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this surah, small surah, Allah promised the hellfire, see the Quran. We're not saying nothing, we're just talking knowledge now. We're not talking about accusing any human being. We're just looking at literally what Allah is telling us. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَهُونَ. Those are neglectful of the time. You know what is this ayah means? It means these people, they pray. They pray, but they do not pray on time. You know, if I keep explaining too much, wallahi, I hope you understand it. Because the time of the prayer, I explained it before. The time of, what is the time of dhuhr? Anybody can tell me quickly?
1 o'clock.
That's the time of the timing? Because it's between and between.
No, it's the sun.
See, that's the problem. Because when I say, when Allah says this ayah, if you do not know the when Allah says, Inna salata kanat. عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. And to be honest with you, I'm just speaking frankly. The more I learn about these things, I never miss my prayer on time. I never miss it. Doesn't mean that I didn't miss the prayer in the masjid. You know why? Because I know the time is not the 1 o'clock, dhuhr. Dhuhr is has Allah's mercy because He promised the hellfire for those who does not pray on time. The time of dhuhr, you know what? It's like 3-4 hours now on the summer. It's from the zawal, which is the when the time is above your head, it's forbidden to pray. When the time, when the sun starts moving to the west, 1 second, 1 minute, this is the beginning of dhuhr. But when the time is above your head, you cannot pray. If you want to know the time of dhuhr, wait until the sun starts making the shade, starts going back to this direction, to the west. This is the beginning. What's the end? The end until the time will go the shade. Until it makes the if you put a stick on the desert and then it has a same shade. Now the time is moving to the beginning of Asr. Now you go into the beginning of Asr. So the time of dhuhr is the beginning of dhuhr until is the beginning of dhuhr until the beginning of Asr. So all of this time is about 3 hours. You see what I'm saying? Now let's say Allah says an. Above the prayer, an. Remove an and put fi. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ سَهُونَ. We all be in the hellfire. If you remove an and you put fi. You may say it's only level, isn't it? What is the difference? It's between a. You know, just an and then fi. It's two letters, fa and ya. That's nothing. Can you change it? You put all the Muslims in the hellfire. Because what meaning fi, Allah, if you put fi, it means that woe to the people who pray, but in they go away in their thinking, in their heart. So when you pray, you should focus 100%. Allah knows that this is impossible. Since He says this is forgiven. Just fight as much as you can. But just at least pray on time. That's why He puts an versus fi inside the prayer. They are neglecting the prayer from inside. Allah says, no, it's not from in. He says, and above their prayer. Do not miss this. Okay, now, this is the wisdom. Let's transform the same technique, inshallah, to a basic understanding, to the Ramadan. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about the Ramadan? He says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ Whomever saw, it's eyewitness. Shahada means ashhadu. It means actually the word ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. It means Allah, you saw him. You're like ashhadu. I bear witness that there is no God. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, because there is no doubt about Allah, whether you actually see it or not, he's there. Imagine all the atheists, all the people of the world, they disbelieve in Allah. Allah doesn't exist, he still exists. So Allah says, ashhadu. Whether you like it or not, Allah is there. It's like the eyewitness. Now, transform this to the beginning of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, فَمَنْ At least one person. In this, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ فَمَنْ شَهِدَ مِنْكُمُ الشَّهْرَ فَلْيَصُمْ Whomever saw an eyewitness the month of Ramadan, they should fast. This is one proof that Allah, no, he could have said, إِذَا وُلِدَ الشَّهْرُ فَصُومُ Can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say this? If the month was born, you can pray. Allah didn't say this. Did Allah didn't know Arabic? We already proved that Allah knows between an and fi. Allah knows the difference with the creator of the universe. Now, nobody can change the word from shahida to born, to wulida. Allah says, فَمَنْ شَهِدَ He didn't say, إِذَا وُلِدَ الشَّهْرُ فَصُومُ This is one of the biggest, that's one thing in the Quran. The second proof in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, it is Allah, let me read the ayah for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, about the ahilla, وَجَعَلْنَاهَا مَوَاقِيتَ لِلنَّاسِ That Allah has made the beginning of the moon, the crescent, as the timing for your ibadat. As a timing for your ibadah. The crescent. Now, look at the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet ﷺ, he says, there's two things that the Prophet did actually in this hadith. If you collect them, one of them it says, like this one, he says, وَصُومُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ وَأَفْطِرُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ The Prophet ﷺ, he's commanding, he says, fast, as a command, he says, fast when you see it, لِرُؤْيَتِهِ, when you saw it, when you see the moon, he says, fast. And break the fast, when you see, which is Eid. And وَأَفْطِرُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ And break your fast, break your Ramadan, you know, fast, you fast on Ramadan, when you saw it again. So this is what he says. And then look at the other one, it's amazing hadith. And all of them it's hadith sahih. And then he says, وَلَا تَصُومُوا Okay, remember this qa'idah in sharia. He says, the negation is more than the affirmation. And النَّهْيُ أَشَدُّ مِنَ الْإِتْبَادِ Well, I give you an example. You know the negation of a hadith of Allah or anything in Sharia, the negation is more powerful than the affirmation. I give you an example. If Allah says, do not do something, and then in other places He says, do this and do this and do this. Which one is more powerful to follow quickly? No doubt. Which one?
Do not do.
Why? We have a proof. Because this is something that is haram, stay away from. The other one is so many of them do this and do this, you know. But there is a hadith about this. He says, مَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ فَأْتُوا بِهِ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ وَمَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا Look at this beautiful. He says, whatever I command you to do, bring as much as you can. The best of you. Bring the best of you. The things that I commanded you. وَمَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ And whatever I forbid you, he says, stop doing it. So from there, the ulama, they say the negation is more powerful than the affirmation, than do. Do not is more than do. But this hadith, it says, you know what? وَلَا تَصُومُوا إِذَا حَالَ بَيْنَكُمْ Do not fast if it was between you and the crescent. Look, this is powerful, I found. This is my proof to the people who go by the astronomical stuff. He said, and do not fast. You know, remember I was proving to you, do not is more powerful than do, because the other hadith, it says, صُومُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ He says, fast when you see. Okay, that's fast. Somebody says, well, you know, I can do as much as possible. No, but there is a hadith that says, do not fast if it was an obstacle between you and the moon. If you have an obstacle, what kind of obstacle? The cloud. If it's cloudy day, the Prophet says, do not fast. Even if the moon is behind the cloud. This is wallahi, it's amazing. But that's a hadith sahih. We cannot remove them, we can throw them away. And says, you know what? Such and such Smith, you know, he got a big machine. We're going to follow sahih, you know. No, you follow the Sharia. And the reason, the wisdom why, like I said, we don't say that the astronomical calculation are wrong. No scholar would say this. We only say, listen, if you understand only this point, you learn something. This is the rahmah of Allah for the human being. Why you make the tithe? You know, we know that the calculation is right, mashallah. We do not disagree with this. Allah says, learn science, learn as much as you can. إِنْ اسْتَطَعْتُمْ أَن تَنْفُدُوا مِنْ أَقْطَارِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فَانْفُدُوا. If you have the ability and the power to penetrate through the heavens and the earth, just go. مِنْ أَقْطَارِ السَّمَاوَاتِ. Allah says penetrate, and this is the indication of astronomy. 1400 years ago, they didn't even know about this. But Allah is telling the people to go to the moon. Allah is not afraid of anybody that he's gonna find something. And no, Allah is beyond this universe. He's the creator of the universe. There is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, and if I keep talking, I take too much time, but I'm going to stick on the topic, that the Prophet ﷺ, he looked at the sky and he says, this sky that is above us, it's 500 years thickness. If you keep going, it's 500 years. And once you get to the 500, he says, above it is ocean. It's an ocean. Baharun, baharun. He says, the thickness of it, 500. مَسِيرَةَ خَمْسُمِئَةِ عَامٍ. He says the distance of 500 years. And you remember we have seven of them. And then the hadith keeps going and keeps going and keeps going. And then he says, and then the seventh one, he says seven, it's also 500 years thickness. Above it is an ocean. Look how many, seven oceans and seven skies. And each sky is 500 years thickness. And each ocean is 500. And then the last one above the seven heaven, the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا الله. Wallahi, this is the powerful hadith. وفوقه عرش الرحمن. And above it is عرش الرحمن, the throne of Allah. لا إله إلا الله. When I read this hadith, it's amazing. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he says, penetrate this heaven, heaven. You as like the ants is trying to go to from one distance to another distance for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. But Allah wants to make this simple, simple for a human being to understand. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he says, and now he said, فَإِذَا غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ. If it was cloudy day, he says, now he says, count as 30, Sha'ban. I can see nothing. It's dark. It's rainy. I can see nothing. Sha'ban is 30. The next day, you don't have to look for the moon. Fast. The first day of Ramadan. Simple, simplicity. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he uses. So, قَالَ إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الْهِلَالَ فَصُومُوا إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ فَأَفْطِرُوا فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَصُومُوا 30 يَوْمًا. This is hadith sahih. He says, if you see it, you fast, and then when you see it, you break fast. The other hadith, he said, do not fast until you see it. If it's cloudy, just continue Sha'ban 30, and the next day will be Ramadan. And there's no complication. This is what I found actually amazing. But all of those I mentioned here, alhamdulillah, that's good. This is one of the things. So as Muslims, we go by the eye. And there is so many ahadith, Abdullah ibn Umar. One of the beautiful hadith that tell you that this religion is made simple. A'rabi came to Rasulullah. He says, Ya Rasulullah, ara'aytu al-hilal. I saw the crescent. He says, atashhadu an la ilaha illallah? Do you believe that there is no God but Allah? And Muhammad is Rasulullah? He says, yes. He says, tell the people to fast tomorrow. Did he talk to him? Who are you? Or did you study? Are you astronomer? Are you? He says, Ya Allah, I saw the crescent. Just right there. He said, do you believe in Allah? Are you Muslim? Because shahada of the disbeliever is not accepted. This is a matter of the deen. This is a matter of religion. Tomorrow we are going to fast. He has to be a trustworthy person. He can see the moon and this. Okay, the other complication, which is wahdatul matali', the unification of one day. Is the Muslims are allowed to fast, all of them, in one day? No. No scholar has ever said this. If you study deeply, and you understand, no scholar has ever said that all the Muslims of the world, they should follow Mecca and fast with them. And if you do, no problem. If you follow Mecca, no problem. If you follow your city, no problem. As long as you see or somebody saw and spot the moon and you're looking. For example, in America, Somebody will tell us in Sarasota, or maybe in California, I saw the moon. Inshallah, we live in under the same place. You know, we don't have one day difference. We only have maybe 3 hours difference from here to there. So if one of them saw it over there, all of us should fast. No problem. But we have to have one person who can see it. If we cannot see it, cloudy, we finish the Sha'ban 30, and the next day becomes Ramadan. This is one thing. The other thing, أخطاؤنا في رمضان. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said, you should not fast on Sha'ban if you're not used to fast. Because get ready for Ramadan. And do not mix the days of Ramadan with Sha'ban. And this is, I already mentioned this. There is a hadith of this. We don't have also the Sha'bana. That's in the bid'ah. That's in the middle of Sha'ban. They celebrate and they give food and they practice certain things. There is not even half of a hadith about that. Okay. الحساب الفلكي. We already دخل الشهر. Oh, inshallah. We already said this. Okay. The other thing of the mistakes that we do in Ramadan, and the majority of the people are not this. Alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inshallah, this topic will be also shared with the people who are not here at this moment. That they only come in Ramadan and they disappear after Ramadan. This is one of the biggest mistakes. Alhamdulillah, when somebody comes, this is the mercy of Allah. Wallahi, I cannot imagine Islam without Ramadan. Because Ramadan actually, there is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said that the abwab al-jannah, the doors of Jannah will be open. And not even one, the doors of Jannah will be open and none of them will stay closed. And then he says the doors of the hellfire will be locked and none of them will be open. And then he says, وَتُصَفَّدُ مَرَدَةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. I'm going to explain to you this. And the shayateen, the doors of Jannah will be open, not even one will be closed. The doors of the hellfire will be locked and none of them will be, the Prophet ﷺ, he says, none of them will be open. This is mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he says, وَتُصَفَّدُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. In another hadith, مَرَضَةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. The evil ones of the devils will be locked and chained. But somebody may tell me, brother, there is still people in this world who does evil. And we already know that the shayateen are the cause of evil. What is your explanation? You heard this before? You heard this? You say, shaytan is locked. Why still people just don't believe? Why people still fornicate, they drink alcohol, what happened? Two meanings of this. The first meaning is that Allah, there is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, when you fast, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَجْرِي فِي بْنِ آدَمَ مَجْرَى الدَّمِ. You remember the hadith that the shaitan, the devil, they ran on the blood of the human being, on the blood of the veins of the human being. So when you have the shaitan is running, and when you're fasting, your blood is pressure is low. And your blood, your veins are so tight, because there is not too much food. Which when you eat, when you drink, you know, the blood is running. But we don't eat, you don't drink for the whole day. What happened? You constricting, you strangling the shaitan. The devil, the shaitan that runs in the heart of the people and the blood, then it becomes constricted. This is one of the meanings of the وَتُصَفَّدُ مَرَضَةُ الشَّيَاطِينَ. Okay? That's why the people on the Ramadan, the Muslims, talking about it, their evil is low down. Okay, now you tell me some people even they get worse. What do you get the meaning? Like we have another meaning. So each one of them is the same meaning. The other one is that the shaitan, and this is my favorite one, he's working on the people 24-7 to do something bad. And if it's 24-7 for 10, 20 years, he doesn't have a work anymore. I heard this from the ulama. What happened? You become like a robot. You become actually a devil. Actually, that's that. If you copy already what he's programming. So you keep doing. So the shaitan, he's going back. You're still doing the same thing. You know, we used to teach people acrobat before. And then when we train them, we start them by the hand. We put a robe, we put a tie, and then we keep training them. But one time we trick them. We put the hand and then we remove the hand. And he thinks, the guy who's training, he get afraid. But now, I remove my hand. He doesn't know I remove my hand. So what happened? He's still flipping. Shaitan, he does this to people. He trained them to do haram. He trained them, he forced them, he tempted them. He said, go ahead, drink this, do this. Go, talk in the phone, do this haram. At the beginning, you don't want, you resist to do the stuff. But once in a while, you do, the first day you don't like it. The second day you don't like it. The third day, but after 1, 2, 30, 10 years, that's it. The shaitan already works on it. That's the two meaning. Number one is this, that he trained the people, and then when Allah chained them, the people still doing the haram. Why? Because they are trained. Wallahi, this is no contradiction in the hadith if you open your mouth. So this is, and we do this in the dunya. We have this in the dunya. We train to do something, and then sometimes you work in a factory, you do something for maybe 10 hours a day for so long. When you are home, you keep doing the same thing, or like your hand is moving a certain way. You know why? Because you trained. Same thing for the ma'asiyah, for evil. That's one of them. And then the other meaning, so remember these two meanings, because it took me long to find them out. The other meaning, which one? So we have one is, shaitan trained the people until he doesn't have to be with them, they still do the haram.
Nafs.
The other thing is, in the shaitan, يَجْرِ فِي بْنِ آدَمَ مَجْرَى الدَّمِ. The shaitan, hadith says, he ran in the blood of the bloodstream of the human being. And when you fast, what happened? You are strangling him. You are making it so hard for him. So even if he ran, he doesn't have anything to pop. So you are safe in Ramadan. فَإِنَّهُ لَهُ وِجَاءَ. That's why the people who are not married, the Prophet ﷺ, he said the hadith, فَعَلَيْكَ بِالصَّوْمِ. He advised them to fast. And then he says, why? He says, فَإِنَّهُ لَهُ وِجَاءَ. It means a protection. If you're not married, your blood is pumping, and you eat 2 pounds of meat all the time, so your blood and your desire and your hormones are pumping. So what are the Prophet ﷺ? He says, beautiful advice. He says, fast. Ya ma'ashar al-shabab. He's talking to the youth. Beautiful hadith. You can learn from it. So he said, when you fast, you this. The other thing about Ramadan is as-salat. As-salat is supposed to be on time. In Ramadan, double. You have to make effort. Why? Because Ramadan is a school. It's a training process. It's a training thing. So if you do not pray in the masjid in the other days in Ramadan, try to pray Fajr on time, Dhuhr on time, Asr on time, and so on. If you do it for 30 days, you're more likely to do it forever, inshallah. And until the next Ramadan. And some people know, they fast, they think fasting is the time of relax. They spend the whole night, this is another topic, another mistake, is that the people actually, they spend the whole night watching TV, watching movies, watching celebrities, football, all kind of games. But the month of Ramadan, it may never come again. Allah has given us this opportunity to get closer. Because Ramadan is a self-improvement program. And if you know this, you read the verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah Ta'ala says, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ أَيَّامًا مَعْدُودَاتِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. In order to be pious, in order to learn self-improvement. So this is the thing. In Ramadan, you should keep your Salat al-Jama'ah. Start from Fajr. The other mistakes we do is we do not have suhoor. Now the other thing is, let me see, because I don't have them organized, but let me tell you, these two things very important. What is the definition? What is the Ramadan? What is the arcane of Ramadan? I want you to learn. Since you come here, you learn these two things. Like Salat has arcane, wudu has shuruq, has condition. What is the conditions of Ramadan? Ask anybody today, wallahi, he may not tell you. No, this is again the pillars of, I skipped that one. I'm coming back to that one. It's my fault. But the other thing, I'm talking about the pillars of the conditions of fasting. Niyyah. That's good.
You have to be like the age.
That's the shuru, but this is the other. Of course you have to be Muslim. You have to have aql. This is shuru. Yeah. This one's here, the condition, the arcane, rukn, is the like the pillars. There is condition, there is pillars. I'm sorry, this is very important. There's a difference between the rukn is inside the fasting. The conditions is outside. And ulama, they explain this, and it's not too many people can grasp it. There is shurut and there is arkan. What's the difference between a shart or rukn? In fiqh, they teach you this. The shart is outside the things, outside the ibadah, outside. Is like you said, the aql, halm, you have to be a Muslim. So it's outside. But the condition is inside. is something to do with the salat. Allahu Akbar, raising the hand. The other ones are outside. Wallahi, it took very long time to understand the difference between a shart or rukn. The shart is the condition. A rukn is the pillar. The arkan, you know, the pillar. So now the rukn of an arkan of the siyam is two. And niyyah, it's rukn because it has to be there. You cannot just wake up in the morning and then you go to work and then you say, oh, you know what, I'm fasting. You have to, before Fajr, you have to make intention. And if you just have a date for suhoor, that's intention. You don't have to say, it's a bid'ah to say, nawaitu siyama ghadan. It's not like this. It's wrong. You just have it in your thought. Just thought about it. Like when you come to the Maghrib, did you stand up in your door and you say, you know what, I'm going to Masjid al-Noor for Maghrib? Or you just key and put the key on your car. That's intention. Because what happened? You must not go into the casino, or you go into the masjid. So the intention only in Hajj. In Hajj you have to say loud, out loud. But any other conditions of any other niyyah, it should be in the mind. So that's one intention. The other one is al-imsaku. Look at the second pillar. Is al-imsaku, to stop eating and drinking and sexual desire from sunrise to right dawn, from dawn all the way to sunset, biniyati ta'abbud, with the intention of worshiping Allah. You have to add this one. You know what I'm saying? You have to stop eating and drinking and sexual desire, and actually they call them anything of that breaks your fast. You have to stop from anything that may break your fast. And mostly we know it's eating, drinking, and sexual desires, and all that. Sometimes, you know, you put some drop in your nose, and it goes to your halq. That will break your fast. You have to make sure that the drops that you put in your ear or on your nose, they don't go through your halq, your throat. If it goes through here, it means you broke your fast. That's something. So do it in another time, probably after Maghrib or right before Fajr. So the conditions of Ramadan, of fasting, number one is the intention to fast for the sake of Allah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا, there's all the ayat, إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. This is the niyyah. And then the other one is al-imsak, above, is to stop and to refrain from anything that will break your fast. To stop from anything that will break your fast. You know, some people don't know that, you know, touching your wife, they think it may break your fast. Or kissing your wife, it's not. And so many people, they ask so many ulama, it's not. The Prophet ﷺ, he used to kiss his wife, and he used to hug his wife, or shake hand, or touch, and then go to make salat, and in the time of fasting. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, his wife, they are allowed to speak about those things. So to clarify for the ummah, this is not of the negation. Unless, with one condition, if you cannot control yourself, then stay away. Other than this, that's natural thing, it's normal. It's like when you kiss your daughter or you kiss your dad, it's natural. The other one, even for shahwa, but the shahwa is not considered anything beyond this. You are married to this woman for 16, 17, 18, 20 years. This is not a negation of your fasting. It will not nullify your fasting. So that the Prophet ﷺ, he says this, unless it will exceed your shahwa or maybe turn you on or something, then you stay away from it. But other than this is not. So this is the niyyah. Now the ulama talks about the niyyah. The niyyah, majority of the ulama, they said, make sure you say it every night. Few of them say, one, it's enough for the whole month. You know, the first month, the first day of Ramadan, you are going to be praying Taraweeh, when you go home, suhoor. I'm going to talk about suhoor also quickly. But anyway, it could be possibly some ulama, but the majority of them, they say, because the Prophet ﷺ, he mentioned so many ahadith that I didn't even know about this, actually asking us to make the intention every for the niyyah for every. مَنْ لَمْ يُجْمِعِ الصِّيَامَ فِي اللَّيْلِ فَلَا صِيَامَ لَهُ. I'm looking for the hadith, but actually that's exactly what it says. مَنْ لَمْ يُجْمِعِ الصِّيَامَ قَبْلَ الْفَجْرِ فَلَا صِيَامَ لَهُ. Whomever did not gather his intention of Ramadan to fast the month of the day of Ramadan before Fajr, he says he has no siyam. So the ulama, he says it's better to be safe. to make intention all the time. And the intention doesn't require anything except suhoor. If you missed it one day, the ulama says no problem. Because you have the big intention, which is to fast the whole. So at least you gotta have the one for the whole month. At least to be safe. If you want to have extra, make intention. The intention will make you strong. To make you endure the whole day. The other thing is suhoor. One of the biggest mistakes that we do not make suhoor. Suhoor, the Prophet ﷺ, he says, مَازَالَتْ. Listen to this hadith, wallahi, if you understand. He says, مَازَالَتْ أُمَّتِي بِخَيْرٍ مَادَامُوا يُؤَخِّرُونَ السُّحُورِ وَيُعَجِّلُونَ الْفُطُورِ. He says, my ummah, it's still in a good shape. As long as they delay the suhoor, the night meal, the night, and they hasten to break the fast. As soon as you hear the adhan, also I'm going to give another tip to the mu'addin. But I want to go one by one. Let's talk about these two things. The suhoor, it's the Prophet ﷺ, he said, تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السُّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. He says, have the night suhoor. He says, in the suhoor there is barakah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also praised this mutasahireen. Well, mutasahireen is those people who eat that meal. It has so much barakah. You will feel the whole day that you are so strong. Also, man, there's another one. That's people make mistake. They eat at 12. They finish Taraweeh. They finish Taraweeh, inshallah. They go home. They eat. And then what happened? They eat at 12 or 11:30 and they go to sleep and they wake up till 10 o'clock. They will even miss. Obviously, if you sleep at 11 or 1, you are going to miss Fajr and then all of a sudden you're going to miss Suhoor. So what happened? You are just crazy. You messed it up the whole thing. But the best thing is to you finish Taraweeh, you go immediately and sleep at that moment. Then you woke up right maybe half an hour or even 45 minutes. You don't want to have too much. You have the meal already ready. Because the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, literally he says, do not stop eating when Bilal is making the adhan. Because at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, there was two people making adhan on his time. What the name of the first one we already mentioned? What his name? Bilal. The second one is? Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum. You have to know this. This is two mu'addin of the Prophet Muhammad. Bilal, he used to make adhan maybe half an hour to an hour before the time. So the Prophet, he said, do not stop eating when you hear Bilal. He says, eat and drink, do whatever you want to do. Until Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum wa kana. And Abdullah ibn Ummi Maktoum la yu'addinu hatta, because he was blind. رضي الله عنه وارضاه حتى يقال له أصبحت أصبحت. They tap on him and they say, this is subh, dawn is come dawn. The Prophet ﷺ, he says, لا يغرنكم. Do not be deluded by the adhan of Bilal. Eat and drink. Now, see, this is amazing. Allah, I just don't have time to explain to you this now. Allah, it's amazing. Ilm is noor. Now you find people, they put the timing. It's okay to put the timing. But do not say this is halal and this is haram. Because you are making one of the most dangerous things. وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمُ الْكَذِبُ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ. Allah said, do not utter but your tongue the lies by saying this is halal, this is haram. If somebody is telling you, this is when your suhoor should stop. You should not eat. You know what he's doing? Danger. He doesn't know actually, he doesn't know. But he's doing one of the things dangerous. Allah says, eat and drink. حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ كُلُوا وَشْرَبُوا حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمُ الْخَيْطُ الْأَبْيَضُ مِنَ الْخَيْطِ الْأَسْوَدِ مِنَ الْفَجْرِ. Subhanallah, the Quran is, I don't know. Am I wrong?
No.
I can see these things like clear, like this. Allah says, eat and drink until you see the light, the white light on the sky. But people today, they stop 2 hours and they tell the people to stop 2 hours. They say 3 o'clock is the, what they call it? Imsak. And they know how to say it, Arabic, you know, beautiful to say, Imsak. Do you know what is Imsak? Imsak is supposed to be right 5 minutes before Fajr, my brother. You know, 5 minutes is enough. And if you, the Prophet ﷺ, he said another hadith, if you hear the adhan and you have water in your mouth, finish it. And some brother will come and put a line and he said, brother, finish himself at 3 o'clock, 2 hours before Fajr. Where did you get this from? Allah is telling me in the Quran and the Sunnah, you don't, it's not enough for you to understand, and it's so clear. You know, one Sahabi, he put one thread in his hand, one white and one black. This is what he thought at the time. So he kept looking at the sky and then looked at the light. So he didn't figure it out. He was looking at his hand, the thread, two pieces of twine. So he went to Rasulullah, he said, Ya Allah, I couldn't understand, what is this? He says, it's not like this. He says, the white and the black from the sky of Fajr. See? And then the Prophet ﷺ, he says, he explained it, amazing. He says that there is two Fajr, al-Fajr al-Sadiq wal Fajr al-Kadhi. It's amazing. He already said, he says the Fajr, the truthful Fajr and the lie Fajr, the ambiguous, it's not clear. And it is clear, if you don't want to say the word, he says, as-sadiq wal-kadhib. You know, I translate literally, so I don't cheat you, my brothers. He says, al-fajr al-sadiq, the truthful fajr. And then he says, the lie fajr. But also you can say the clear and the unclear, the ones that, he says, this is the one you stop when it's clear. And then he says, the one who's not clear, he says, the light is going like this, ufuqi. What is ufuqi means? Huh?
Vertical.
What is this one like this? Horizontal. See, there's two lines. This is the line when you stop. When the horizon, when the white is going like this. Because this one, he says, it's a life of you. You know, one sheikh, he was dying in the bed. I've been studying this for 30 years. And I see all of this ulama, he's dying. He says, please tell the ummah to correct the timing of fajr. Because they... And especially you messed up Ramadan. Because if they don't have the right time, you see, alhamdulillah, Masjid al-Norway do it good. Alhamdulillah, brothers, they sing. Because when you're supposed to leave the prayer after Fajr, you should see the light. It's okay. Because Fajr is still okay until sunrise. You know, it's nothing wrong. One time, Abu Bakr Siddiq, I'm not going to be better than Abu Bakr Siddiq. But listen what he said one time. He was praying and he was expanding his prayer. He's lengthening his prayer. The prayer was long, the surah, until the sun was up. They say, Ya Abu Bakr, لقد أشرقت الشمس علينا. He says, the sun is above us. He says, it's better that the sun will see you awake reading the Quran than the sun will see you sleeping. Why? Because you started on the right time. You already started the Fajr on time. So even if you go and say, he's like, but anyway, this is how you explain this. Okay, now Mu'addin, especially Mustafa is waiting for this. When the time of Maghrib will come, which is the course, they say the round of the sun will fall behind. So I know the mountain here and stuff. You do the best you can until you don't see the, you know, you still see the red. You still see the redness. You're not going to wait until you see. Some people, they wait too long. Some people, they break the... No, as long as the sun is behind the mountain, alhamdulillah, you're not going to go and follow the sun and wait. As long as you are enough, you add another. The mu'addin who are going to make the adhan, he should drink before the adhan. Break your fast, because the time in already. You break the fast and then you make the adhan. And the people immediately they hear the adhan, they break the fast. If they are here, they are going to break the fast here and make salat with the jama'ah. And if they are going to break the fast outside in the masjid, they will do it. If not, then they can go home and break, but they don't miss jama'ah. Because how could you fast the whole day and then all of a sudden you miss jama'ah? Maybe one day or something, you have some good, but try. The best thing to do is to break the fast and go on to do. Any question before I keep going? So we talked about ta'khir al-suhur, ta'jil al-futur, immediately. The Prophet said, لا تزال أمتي بخير ما دام يؤخرون السحور يعجل الفطر حتى المؤذن إذا دخل الوقت يأكل ويفطر.
Is that the timing of the one you have in the phone is correct?
The time here on the phone? I don't know too much. I have to see, especially in Ramadan. I have to look outside. I have to look a little bit.
During between Fajr and Shuruq and then
one hour. Yeah, always between.
And then you can pray 1 hour.
No, okay, that's a good answer to that question. Because some people, other people, they did ask that question, which is the shuruq. When you pray shuruq and duha, they are the same. And this is different. Duha and shuruq is the same prayer.
I'm talking about the fajr.
Fajr, yeah.
I'm talking about the fajr. When it started, until the just before the shuruq. Just as, because sometimes it's,
yeah,
you see the light everywhere.
Mm. Oh, it keeps going until sunrise. Right before sunrise.
Yes, right before sunrise.
That's we're talking about jama'ah. I mean, we're doing the jama'ah on the right things, you know. But all of those time, but it's very small. Between, it's, let's say now, what time we pray? 4:45? Okay, now you only have like maybe 15 minutes. And then you have the sun starts coming and you have it limited. You're supposed to pray in jama'ah, that's one thing. That's all the salat supposed to be in jama'ah, that's one of the things. But we're talking about the timing, like we said about the time of Dhuhr, is from the when the sun is above the head and all the way right before Asr. This is 2-3 hours right there. The same thing on Fajr, we have this 20 minutes.
Just like they said.
Right before.
They said from 3:57, that means from 4 o'clock to 5:24. You can still pray Fajr.
You still can pray Fajr. But that's the timing of the Fajr. But the best time is with Jama'ah on the beginning. Also, there is another hadith that the best time is the first of the time. Let's say Dhuhr, the minute the sun starts going to the west, that's the beginning of Dhuhr, it's the best time. Because it has two, one of the beginning and then also the other one is the middle and then also the other. So the best time is to finish your Luqman. Okay, the other thing is the waste. I talk about this, inshallah, maybe in the future. You know, the waste of the food, the waste of this, and then excessive eating. There's many ahadith, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, بِحَسْبِ بْنِ آدَمَ لُقَيْمَاتِ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبَهِ فَإِنْ كَانَ لَا مَحَالَ لَا مَحَالَ فَتُلُتٌ لِطَعَامِهِ وَتُلُتٌ لِشَرَابِهِ وَتُلُتٌ لِنَفَسِهِ. He says, enough for the son of Adam, some morsel of food, to be enough and sufficient to fill him up. He says, but if you have to, you have to. He says, one third for your food, one third is for your drink, and one third is for your breath. You live to breathe. You know, he says, leave some time to breathe. And if you eat too much, then more likely you are not going to pray Taraweeh properly, or maybe you're going to be, you know, maybe burping or maybe something. And it's like it's to avoid those excessive eating and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, kulu washrabu. The other thing, he said, wala tusrifu. Some people in Ramadan, they think they are going to eat too much, they get so many plates, and all of a sudden they eat a little bit, and then they waste the food. The Prophet Muhammad, he saw pieces of the food next to Aisha in the floor. He said, and ghadab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was so angry. He says, Ya Aisha, ahsini jiwara ni'ami rabbik, fa wallahi ma dahabat, aw rahalat ni'amullahi an ahadin ma raja'at ilayhi. He says, the closest meaning, he says, be careful of the ni'mah of Allah. More likely the ni'mah or the blessings of Allah, if it's go away from a person, it may never come back to him. So the more you throw in here and here and here, one day may Allah if you see a person wasting food, he may take it away from him. I think we talk about a little bit. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين. If you have any question, or you'll get to go, no? زاكم الله.